I guess I really don't know what Christmas is all about. Isn't there anyone who knows what Christmas is all about?
I can tell you what Christmas is all about.
Chestnuts roasting.
Hi YouTube, welcome back to my channel. Yes, it's Ms. Excalibur, back with another like show and tell, I suppose. I'm just going to show you some of the new eyeshadow palettes that I've accumulated over the last, I'd say, 4 or 5 months, maybe more. And I'm going to be possibly using them, well, most likely using them in my Vlogmas, and just in various tutorials. But I just wanted to show you them before I actually use them. So starting off with the Coastal Scents, and this is the Smoky Eye palette. So it's a 36 eyeshadow palette, so I haven't used it as yet. Those of you that follow me on Instagram, you would have seen like little pictures and little teasers of it. So let's see. Yeah, the colors are beautiful. I think they are quite comparable to the Anastasia and Subculture palette. This section here, like over here, yeah. So you can see like the colours and the yellows and stuff. So I'm really excited to use that. I haven't really swatched them, but I suppose I'll see what they're like with when I use them. So that's that one, Coastal Scents. I'm trying to just mainly focus on the palettes. I have bought some other bits and bobs, but depending how this video goes, I don't want it to be too long. So that's that palette. It's a nice palette actually. Then on to some more Coastal Scents. So these are the Socialize. Now they come in a pack of three. Let me just show you the pack it comes in. So it's called Stylize. And then it's like a little, like a video case thing, and they slot in. And these are really, really cheap. I got these in the summer, and they're having a silly half price sale on Coastal Scents. So I ordered that from the website, and you get these three, and I think I paid $8 for them. Ridiculous, like as a set. I'll show you what they look inside. Beautiful. That one's Glamour Eyes, which I am going to be using over my Vlogmas. Beautiful, absolutely beautiful palette. This is Formal Eyes, which is a bit more neutral. The pigmentation on them, I've swatched a little bit of them, they're really, really nice. And this one's called Socialize. Yeah, that's more neutrals, a bit more darker. And you've got like it looks grey, but it's like it's more black. So, and like I said, I think they were the $8 or something. I will put all the information in the description bar below so you can have a look. Then onto the Neutrals Versus Neutrals by Makeup Revolution. This is a really nice palette. This is what I've got on today. So I was going about Makeup Revolution because they're affordable and their products are really, really good. I've said it before, they're comparable to MAC. So let me just show you. Look at that. Now, I love, as you can see, I've hit pan on some of them. I've had this for about 4 or 5 months, and I've been using it nearly every single day just to create different types of looks. It is a really, really good palette. I had to wait ages for it to come in. It was in popular demand, but I think they've restocked it. I think it's one of their best sellers. So that's an amazing palette by Makeup Revolution. Then onto the Karity palettes. Now, I haven't used them. These are now going for £85 on Amazon. I got the matte and I got the frost. Yeah. On Amazon, they're £85. I paid £12 each for them on Amazon last year, and I've not really used them. I've used them in one of my red eye makeup looks, but that was it. So let me just show you the matte clarity palette. These are really pigmented. They're really, really nice eyeshadows, really soft, very creamy. Yeah, they're not as pigmented as I thought they would be, probably because as a makeup artist, I'm used to using a really high pigment. And when I say high pigment, I'm talking about stage eyeshadows. Let me just show you what I mean. This is Screen Face. I've hit pan on that, but it's taken me, look at the pigment of that. That wasn't even a full swipe. Let me just, I'm so scared to even touch it. They are equivalent to Juvia's Place. I can see that's why so many makeup lovers, makeup artists and makeup enthusiasts really love Juvia's Place, because the payoff, the pigment, it's amazing. So I'm going to show you the Frost palette. I haven't used this yet, so that's going to be used in for Vlogmas as well. Yeah. They've got quite a few shimmers on as well. Yes, there's a lot of shimmer on that. That's an unusual colour. It looks pinky purpley, and it's that one. It looks pinky purpley in the actual pan, but it's actually not. It's got like little silver flecks in it. Yeah, so gonna be used, as I says, £12 on Amazon last year, now £85. I don't know what's going on with that. Then on to the BH Cosmetics 28 color eyeshadow palette. Now these are all right. The pigment's quite nice. They work quite well. Let me just show you properly so you can see. Yeah. I've used them a few times. The pigment, it's so. Sometimes they come up really well. It depends when you wet them. When you wet them, they come up really, really nice. So that's the BH Cosmetics. Got that sent in from America, but they were selling this on Beauty Bay, I think, for £8. So they still might have it. Then onto the Morphe Jaclyn Hill palette. You would have seen me use this in my previous review. So that's that beautiful palette. Yes, I've used it, and I plan to use it a lot more over the Christmas season. Yeah, absolutely beautiful palette. You've got a few of them that are a bit chalky, but not many. I'd say about one or two, if that. Just a beautiful palette, and one of the biggest talked about palettes this year. Then onto Take Me to Brazil. Now, this is such a famous palette. If you don't know, then you need to know. This is one of the famous palettes, Take Me to Brazil. And they've recently launched Take Me to Brazil Part 2. This comes with a mirror, which is really, really good. And as you can see, the colours are so vibrant and just absolutely stunning. I've actually used this on my Brazil look, which I'll leave here. So, that was like a carnival look, and it was inspired by this palette's amazing. The pigmentation on it, everything's just stunning. Really, really, really good palette. Then on to OPV. Now, there's a lot of hype about this, and I've used a few. Maybe I shouldn't be so harsh. Maybe I should use it a little bit more before I make my decision on whether I think it's good enough or not. But yeah, as you can see, the colours, let me just bring them, you're going to block my face for a minute, so let me just, so there's a lot of neutrals, there's only a few colours, like colour ones here, here, and down there, like there's a few, but I that they're really powdery. Some of them are really powdery, and you can see that it's private labeling. It's got private labeling written all over it. It's like, you know, but some of them are really, all the formulas are different, which is, it's a bit weird. Some of the shimmers are nice. It's a so palette, and I got it from the OPV website, but I will be giving it another good go and using it in the Vlogmas tutorials. Then on to the creme de la creme in my view. Creme de la creme for a few reasons. Creme de la creme because they're pocket friendly, they're affordable, and I'm not going to walk around feeling guilty after I spent money on them. And the pigment is amazing. Yes, I'm talking about Juvia's Place. Yes, I've got both of them. Now, I didn't buy both of them at the same time. I wish. I don't roll like that. So I got this one from... This one came from this one came from Beauty Bay. This is when I started to do the Beauty Bay. And this one I got sent from America. Now I got this when they were having 25% off, and I got a family member to send it out. Big up yourself, you know who you are. This is just, they're beautiful. So you know what I love? Yes, they're a black owned brand, and yes, I've heard some controversy about them and stuff like that, but because I think I got it from Beauty Bay, I don't experience any of that. And even when I got the one from the actual Juvia's Place website, I didn't have any problems. Look at that. I haven't swatched any of them, but let me see. Look at the shimmer. Let me just have a look and see. No. Just too... You know what? I just have to incorporate that. Those look beautiful. I think I'm going to put those in a makeup look. And that was just random, picking the random three. Just absolutely beautiful. Actually, let me have a look. Let me just sit. Wow. How did I make them? So that I've swiped, as you've just seen, but look what's left on my fingers. Get scared, such a palette now. That's no joke. Reason why I'm using some tissue, but I've got some oil on it. And even with the oil, it's left a bit of a stain. Oh, don't mess about. Yes. Just make sure when you're using these Juvia Place, you make sure you put a good primer underneath your eye, onto your skin, because they'll stain your skin. I shouldn't really say that. I don't even know. I've never tried it, but from what I've just done on my hand. From what I've just seen on my hand, that's no joke. And then onto the Masquerade palette. Now, what put me off was the pink. As you know, as I keep saying, I'm not a pink person. But when you have a look inside, and I know a lot of you would have seen it, and yes, I'm probably late, but just leave me in my lateness and my ignorance, yeah? So, I've just put that in. Right. So you can see, I've kind of swirled the purple one. I'm not going to do the purple one again because I just did that in the other one, even though it's a different. Oh, let me have a look at this Calibre. Oh wow! Let's do the browns this time. Let's do this one. No way! That's another beautiful eye combo. Stunning. So let's do this thing again. Let's see. So that's a matte one. Oh my gosh. When people say the pigmentation on the Juvia Place palettes is unreal and it's worth the money, it really is. I don't even think you're gonna be able to get through all of that unless you're a makeup artist that does makeup every single day. Stunning palette. So those are the palettes out of the way. Then I just wanted to quickly show you the Makeup Revolution. Yes, and as I keep saying, I'm not sponsored by Makeup Revolution, but these are really good. This is the Holographic Unicorn Lip Kit. Now this one was limited edition, so I've got that one. I've got Empress, which you will see featured in some of my videos, my Vlogmas. And then I've got Matte Lip Contour Kiss of Death. Now that was for the these were the Halloween limited edition. Both these two were for the limited edition, but I like them anyway because I love the contrast. I love, those that know me know I love metallics, and then I also love black lipstick. We're wearing black lipstick, blue lipstick, green lipstick before it became a fashion. I used to make my own blue lipstick with eyeshadow and line it with blue eyeliner. So those of you that know will know what I'm talking about. Yeah, that's beautiful. And it comes with a pencil as well. But the pencil, I got a sneaky feeling, it's just the same eyeliner, you know, the durable eyeliner. Because this pencil, take this off. This pencil is so pigmented. It looks beautiful on the lips. It doesn't really break. Apparently they're saying it's a new improved formula, but I didn't buy the old ones, the other ones. Look at that. That shimmer. Yeah. Yeah. And these, did I buy them on the 3? No, I didn't buy them on the 3 for 2. I wish I did. It's just that when I went in one day, they never had the Retro Luxe, which was that one. It's the last one I'm going to show you. They never had the Retro Luxe Unicorn. And then I found the black one, and then about a month or so later, when these came out, or 2 months later, I bought this. I wish I bought them on the 3 for 2. I normally buy them things like that on the 3 for 2. Now this is the pencil, the lip liner. Can you just look? This has got some beautiful shimmer on it. Let me see if it comes up on my hand. It's absolutely, this is gonna go perfect with those colours I've just selected. You can just about see it. But this is gonna go beautiful. It's got like, it's a purpley blue colour with gold reflex in it. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. And, let me show you some more lip bits I've got. Lip Tarte Obsessive Compulsive Cosmetics. You know how many years I've wanted these, or just to get my hands on one of these. And then I think I got them off, it was either Look Fantastic or Love Makeup, and they were on offer. But I'll put all the information in the description bar below. This is Derelict. Now it's a goldy greeny, I don't even think you're going to be able to see it, a goldy greeny colour, and it's got gold bits in it. So that's absolutely stunning. So this is beautiful. This colour is called Techno Pagan, and this is like a, So under the lights it looks purple, but when you put it on, I suppose it looks blue. Now this should definitely show up. Look at that. It's like a rich royal, let me just get my hand right. A rich royal bluey, it's just absolutely gorgeous. And it's a gloss, so it's beautiful. So I seen Fumi, the one of the YouTubers, her name's Fumi, she, I seen her wear this and she wore it and she just looked absolutely stunning in it. And I was like, I've got to get that blue. Those of you know, me and blues, as you can see, me and blues are just, I just got a thing for blues. So I haven't tried anything of Beauty Bakery, I know I'm a bit behind, but I got the Beauty Bakery Gelato in Mandarin eyeliner. Yes. It's just this beautiful orange. Yes, you're going to be seeing some looks with the orange. And I got the Beauty Bakery setting powder, and I got this in colour brown flower. Now I did want the yellow flower, I think that's called, but they didn't have it, and they had this on offer. I've used it once, I haven't got it on today, but I've used it once and it was a bit red. So what I did was I counteracted it with the Makeup Revolution banana powder. So what I did was I did the powder under the foundation trick first, and it came out all right. It wasn't too bad, but yeah, I got that on for sale as well. Really cheap, and that was from Love Makeup. So I think that's it. Oh, and I've got the NYC metallic liner. Yeah, I bought a few metallic liners. You would have seen me do a metallic look on my last, on my Morphe Jaclyn Hill palette. That goes really well with that. And I finally got my hands on the Gerard Cosmetics Slay All Day. This is all that. Yes, I know I'm extremely late on the hype on this, but this, let me just show you the new, let me advertise the front properly. Slay All Day. This is beautiful. And I got mine in the green tea fragrance, and it just perks you up. It keeps you fresh. You smell fresh for hours after you sprayed it. What I like to do is, I depending on where I'm going, I like to put on a spray of it first, and then after I've put my powder on and dusted it off, because I use a lot of the buffing method as well. Once I've used the buff the powder off, I then spray this again. It's beautiful. I got this on offer on Beauty Bay. It's beautiful. It's really nice. I use a lot of setting sprays. I do like the Benai. I have got the Maheran one that you put underneath. I forgot what one's called. But I find that the Maheran and the Benai, they're amazing. They do last and they hold your products all day. It's just the alcohol in it, the astringent of it. It's it's not for everyday use. This definitely Slay All Day. You can use this every day. You can take, you can feel like it's, let me see if it's got any alcohol in it. Yes, it has. You can feel the alcohol in it, but I don't think the alcohol content is as much as the Benai setting spray. But yeah, they're just really good. So hope you enjoyed this show and tell, and showing you some of the palettes I'm going to be using for Vlogmas and in the near future. And yeah, please like and subscribe. I just want to say thank you so much to my new subscribers. Thank you for those that are following me on Instagram. Thank you for those that hit me up on Twitter. It's really encouraging, and I don't think you realise how encouraging it is. Because sometimes I see my views, I see my numbers, and I think, oh, I think, is it really worth this effort? But for those of you that have subscribed, it's worth it for you, if that makes sense. So thank you so much. So yeah, see you on the next one. Yes, it's only 2 weeks till Christmas. Yes, so this is part of my Vlogmas series. So this is the showing you the palettes, all the different type of palettes that I've got, which I've accumulated over the last few months. But yes, this is for my Vlogmas. Enjoy.